नमस्ते बच्चों, मैं निशा खुशरो, माई सेल्फ जेवियन डॉक्टर मोनिका त्रिवेदी एंड फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी, फैकल्टी ऑफ एजुकेशन एंड मेथोडोलॉजी, ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर. सो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडेज टॉपिक इज इंटेंसिटी ऑफ अ स्पेक्ट्रल लाइन. इन प्रीवियस क्लासेज वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द रोटेशनल स्पेक्ट्रा एंड द टाइप्स ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल्स. ओके, and as well as we have discussed about the non rigid rotor. Okay, for today's class we will discuss the intensity of a spectral line. Okay, for the transition and other than the del g is equals to plus minus 1, which are forbidden, and the transition probability is zero, and the probability of all changes with del j is equals to plus minus 1 is almost the same. This does not mean that all the spectral line will be equally intense. Okay, here you can see the diagram of the spectral line intensities. Now what is the effect of isotope substitution? Here you can see the 12CO and 13CO, these are both are isotope. And what happened for the energy level of both of these molecules is different. So if we see that the 12C16O is converted into 13C16O, the mass increases, the B, the value of B decreases, so that the I that is B is proportional to 1 by I, so the energy level low. So here you can see that the level of energy of 13CO is less as compared to 12CO. So for the isotope, the energy level decreases because of the mass is increased. Now if we compare of the rotational energy level in a 12CO and the 13CO, the isotope masses accurately to within the 0.02% of other method for atom in a gaseous molecule. Okay, if we calculate that the isotope of both of these, for example 12CO has a g is j is equals to 0 is converted into j is equals to 1 at 3.84235 centimeter inverse. For 13CO, it has absorption band on 3.67337. Okay, so the given what we have changed 0.02%. Okay, so for 12 carbon, we have that 12.000, and for carbon it is 15.9994 amu, the rotational energy levels. Now what is the rigid rotor, non-rigid rotor? In practical, spectrum line are not exactly same as the theoretical line, so the separation decreases with increasing in a value of j. The molecule stretched and become non-rigid with increase in a rotation. So therefore, a correlation term containing the centrifugal distortion constant, which is denoted by D and which correlates for the fact of the bond, is non-rigid. Okay, this is the configurational force which is applied on a molecule when molecule rotating. Now what is this, how the spectrum of a non-rigid rotor? You can see the spectrum of a non-rigid rotor. For this you can see the rotation from 0 to 10, and this is the value for the j, and you can see here for the rigid rotor and for non-rigid rotor, the values are changed, and our rotational energy levels are also change. You can see that the energy levels in a non-rigid rotor is lower as compared to the rigid rotor. You can see the after the fifth level, the energy level started decreasing for a non-rigid rotor, because after rotation, the molecule feel much spread, and it become a non-rigid. Okay, so by this equation you will calculate the value of centrifugal distortion, which is d is equals to h cube 32 pi 4 I 2 r square kc centimeter inverse. And applications of microwave spectroscopy. The microwave spectroscopy is used in a chemical analysis, and rotational spectra of substance at the room temperature can be examined, and it can also use in a molecule identification in space. The electronic spectroscopy has been able to detect the presence of a various atom ion and a few radicals in the light of a stars, but recently the simple stable molecule in a space detected by using the microwave spectroscopy. 130 molecules or ion have been identified in the interstellar space by their rotational emission spectroscopy. So this is all about the non-rigid rotor and the application of a microwave spectroscopy. Thank you very much.